you can hear us. That would be most helpful.
Right, everybody, let me know if you can hear me okay. We're just having a few technical issues. Let me know if you can hear us. Just leave a comment in the chat box, please. We do have Tony Seaborn here as well. He's going to commentate on today's game for this area final. So just let me know. Right, you can hear us. Okay. Right, what we're going to do then, because that doesn't seem to work. We've got a splitter here. And let's see if we...
So I can't hear you.
No. Let's just see if we plug this in. Just took it out, hang on. Right, let me know everybody if you can hear me okay. We're just making a few adjustments. Back, right, okay. So we're just trying to make just making a few adjustments here, just so right, so that first end then. That first end was 5. So Wayne picked up a 5 in that first end then. So great end for Wayne and Bex. Alright, if you can just bear with us for a little bit, we're just trying to figure a couple of things out. But the stream is working fine, we're just trying to sort the audio out. I'm just making sure You can hear better than yesterday. Okay. Well, we're just trying to work out how to get Tony on here as well, because we've got a splitter, but it doesn't seem to be working very well for some reason. I don't know. I don't know why. Well, what I'll do then for now is I will hand you over to my good buddy Tony while I work on the stream. So,
evening, guys. Hope you can hear us. Well, Bex and Wayne have had worse first ends, that's for sure. Picking up a 5 on end one. It's not a bad way to start a final. Can you hear us okay, everyone? If you could just let us know, that'd be great. Thank you. A few technical difficulties here this evening. It's not always easy picking up the Wi-Fi, these bowls clubs. If you could just let us know, that'd be great. Thank you. Bex has certainly found her line and length already. She's holding 3 at the moment on the second end and just putting a back bowl. Jenny's coming in now, but she's just a shade high according to Roger. Don't think Wayne can complain too much at what Bex has just left him. Holding 3 and a back bowl. Wayne with his first delivery of this end. Got his familiar aero bowls. Just trying to match up. Jenny's just behind the head. Good bowl. Good bowl there. Splits those bowls. Roger under a bit of pressure already. And it's only end 2. Watching it like a hawk. Just over the pace again. Some of you might actually recognise Roger. He actually won the senior national pairs 2 seasons ago at Nottingham with his partner Richard Pope. So, used to pressure situations. All over the line there, just dropped a few feet short of what he wanted. Roger's not wasting any time, he's down to this now, playing with weight, trying all the head. Well, he's got one out. Got a feeling he's still 2 down on the head. Wayne just looking to add a foot on his last bowl. I won't tell you what Wayne just said. Hopefully you didn't hear that, but he was a little bit tight. if anything, he just widened the target for Roger a bit. Roger's just the one down now. Roger's third delivery of this end. Playing with less weight this time. Oh, did coming off of Wayne's bowl, but not enough to change the position. Still Wayne and Beck's holding one. Wayne with his last delivery of this end. I think he likes this one a little bit better. Can he miss that front bowl of his? He's not far away. Not far away at all. Oh, what a bowl. Oh, just fell out. Not sure if that's second or not. Roger telling his partner, Jenny, that he's going to try and play a tighter line with a yard on, see if he can alter the head. Certainly playing a tighter line with a bit more weight with this bowl. Looking to change things. Just tight across the head, unfortunately, for Roger and Jenny. So Bex and Wayne picked up another couple to go stretch their lead to 7-0 after two ends. Bex is certainly leading very well at the start of this game. Obviously been an England player for quite some time. So you expect her to be pretty close to it. Jenny's got a good reply here. Yeah, good effort from Jenny. I've got a little bit of a personal interest in this game also, because Jenny, bless her, has decided to play mixed pairs with myself outdoors at Acol this coming season. She obviously does a lot of work for charity, our Jenny. Should be fun anyway, looking forward to it. Great effort here from Jenny, just needs to run a bit more. Yeah, good second there. Beck's not quite reaching with this one, I don't think. are you up, Jen? Not quite reaching. Nope. Need another 4 feet on that. Good yard, 4 feet. Beck's looking to add another. Got one right behind it at the moment. And she ain't far away here either. Well played, Bex. Good bowl there. Very good bowl. That's not going to make things any easier for Jenny and Roger.
So we're shuffling them up there.
Just missed. Well, the umpire's going to be called on to do some work.
Just do a quick test. I'll just do a quick test.
So, can I? If you could let us know. So you're having a few technical difficulties at the moment, which we apologise. It looks like the umpire has given it to Bex and Wayne. So its current score is 8-0 after three ends.
Just ask if they can hear you okay.
Can you hear us, guys? If you wouldn't mind just letting us know, that'd be brilliant. Thank you. It'd be nice to know that you can hear what's going on. You probably don't want to listen to me all night, but just be nice for Paul to know that picture and sound is okay. Willgress' first bowl, just gone a yard through. Looking for a good first bowl here from Jenny. Weight doesn't look too bad at all. Yeah, good start, Jen. Very good. Well played. Busy few days ahead, really, for Wayne and Bex. They both qualified for the national finals, the Champion of Champions at the weekend, which is taking place at Dolphin in Poole in Dorset. One of my favourite clubs, I must admit. Went there last year for the finals of the Champion of Champions with son Dan, who qualified for the first time. Was really impressed. What a lovely club and great people as well. Really enjoyed it down there. So Bex and Wayne are both qualified in their events, which start this coming Saturday. So good luck to the pair of them. He's made a much better start this game, this end. Very good, Jen. Well played. Well played. That's much better from the ankle pair. It's looking to get in there. Not far away. Not a million miles away here at all. Oh, what a bowl. What an effort that was from Bex. Still two down. His weight don't look too bad. Not too bad at all. Well played. Well played, Jenny. Yeah, Roger seems quite happy with that. Now, are we going to see the first Wayne Willgress bomb of the night? Or is it a nice delicate draw? Time Wayne's been in trouble this evening. Yep, as I thought. Get ready. And here it comes. Well, that's one missed. Just deciding where his first bowl is going to go. If I was him, I'd be putting one behind. I can't see Wayne missing it too many more times. Certainly taking a wide line, Roger. Not bad if this stays on. Yeah, good bowl there. Good bowl there. Comes Wayne again, winding up. See if he likes this one. Think he's a bit closer. Yep. Didn't think he'd miss it twice running. It's a very good hit from Wayne. He was three down. Jack's now in the ditch. I would suggest that Rogers' first bowl of that end is now possibly the shot at the back there. Not quite sure. There is a toucher in the ditch. Not sure that belongs to Wayne and Bex or Roger and Jenny. Looking at Bex's face, it could be theirs in the ditch there. Good evening, Mr. Mosley. Nice to know you're listening in, watching this big game. Hope you're well, my friend. Jenny's waving this one in from Roger. Not quite going to make it, I'm afraid. Yeah, a couple of yards short. Wayne now drawing to the ditch. This will test his mettle. Tell you what, yeah, a million miles away. What a bowl this is. What a bowl. Oh, that is absolute class from the big man. Got to give it to him. Made a bomb with his last bowl and then drew to the ditch. Yeah, it's not a bad effort from Roger. If he can get onto Wayne's bowl, no, just slid into the ditch. Hope you're all hearing this.
Yeah, this evening. Yeah, you've got a voice like butter, apparently.
Voice like butter, someone's just said. That must be that lady I paid this morning. Bless her.
But how do you interpret that? Is that bad for you?
Well, that could be bad, could be good, I'm not quite sure, but at least I've got a voice, I guess. Wayne drawing to the ditch again. Oh, not quite with that one. Just gone a yard short of the ditch. Pressure on Roger again here. Oh, he's trying to run Wayne's bowl off by the looks of things. Jenny looks interested. Oh, great effort, Roger. Oh, that's another end to the Willgresses. Just a single. Really the start the ankle pair wanted, that's for sure. Bex and Wayne 9-0 after four ends up.
Tony just having a quick tea break, so I'm back on the commentary. Yeah, so for some reason we can't quite seem to make it work. Can't quite seem to make it work tonight, so we can both commentate at the same time. Well, great start by Jenny, but we'll try and do it for next time. We'll try and get it all sussed out for next time that we stream, and so both of us can commentate at the same time. I'm sure it's something quite simple, but just keep it. We'll keep it nice and simple tonight. Just use one microphone. Right, I'm just going to go and check the power, because it looks like someone has turned off my socket, so I have no more power.
If you can still hear me, everyone at home. A slight problem with the power at the moment as well, so it's not our night tonight, unfortunately, on the technical side of things. And it's not Jenny or Roger's night either at the moment, but we're only four ends in, so still hope. Paul's having a real night of it tonight. He's mega stressed out, bless him, but that's working with Tony Seaborn. That's what it does to you.
Well, the dream team, yeah.
Paul calls it a dream team. Not sure that's what everyone else calls it.
Nightmare.
Wayne continuing on the path to glory. Bex is currently holding shot. Roger, I think he's just outside the line, unfortunately. Looks pretty good weight again here. Yeah, have a good bolt.
It looks in there, Jenny. It looks just in there.
You see it there? Reach that
one. I'm going to try and come inside the two short poles.
Yeah, we're just going to look to play inside the short poles on this forehand. See if he can alter their head here. Try and make things happen a bit for the pair of them. Oh, just tight across the head, lost that bowl. Wayne's just asking Bex how many they're holding. Quite up with this one. Mm-hmm. just for any of those that might be interested, and I'm one of them, there is a two bowl men's singles semi-final happening tonight at Norfolk Bowls Club. Paul Nichols will be interested in this because he plays the winner in the final. My son Dan is playing against Jake Leslie. That's two players from Norfolk Bowls Club, and Dan is currently 10-7 up. I'll say the winner of that will play Mr. Nichols in the area final. Paul won his semi-final a couple of nights ago, fairly comfortably, although he wouldn't admit it. I watched the game live on the ACOR webcam, and Paul played very well. Started off a bit slow, but once he got into it, sort of ran away with it, really. So I'd like to wish Paul good luck for the final, but if it's Dan, obviously I won't. Anyway, back to this game. Wayne apologising, slightly wide of the head this time. Roger do with his last bowl. He needs to get on the scoreboard, give himself the chance. Not much of a reaction from Jenny. Two to Bex and Wayne. Takes the score to 11-0 after five ends. Couldn't really ask for a bad start. Not the final anyway. Tonight's game, I believe, goes through to the area, the national finals, sorry, which this year I believe are being held at Bristol Indoor Bowls Club. Weekend of the 25th of February, I believe it is. So a change of venue for the finals for the mixed pairs and mixed fours, obviously. Because I think the last two seasons it's been held at St. Neots. Good start from Bex again. She's certainly playing very, very well at the moment. I watched her get against Catherine the other night in the national singles. That was one hell of a game. She ended in a 21-19 victory for Catherine. Catherine had to bring out one hell of a bomb on the last end to win the game. Oh, Jenny's just drawn the shot. That's good. Good for Jen. Get her confidence. Mm-hmm. is close here. Bex is very close here. Wowza. Yeah, that's the shot she's just drawn. Not really giving Jen or Roger any opportunities at the moment. Yeah, it's false Jenny to just go slightly over and wait. Gone a good 4 feet, 5 feet through. Bex is close again here. Wow. Poetry in motion, this is from Bex. Wayne certainly picks his partners. Jenny's got an effort here, I tell you. Get back into the head. Oh, just gone through. Another good effort from Jenny. Well, Bex must be a skip's dream at the moment, the way she's playing. Wayne's looking to put another one in there. Yeah, Jack Eye Bowl. Now, Roger. Let's be having you. The fight back starts here. Drawing at the moment. Looks to be just going across the head. His weight wasn't too bad. Well, his weight was good. Just slightly under the line. Got a feeling Wayne's going to like this. Got a feeling he ain't far away at all. It was just bend underneath Jenny's back bowl. Oh, what an effort that was. Jenny says Bex and Wayne still hold two. Right, Roger, what are you made of? Jenny's looking interested. Jenny's looking interested. He's close here. Just needs good contact. Well played. Great bowl, Rog. Looks like shot from here. Be looking for a similar pace to the last ball. No, he's not going to hold that. Not on that line. Yeah, he was just playing with good 4 or 5 feet of pace there. He was under the line. Roger's walking back with a smile on his face. praying that he can hold on to this one and get on the board. Slightly wider line here for Roger. Erring on the side of caution, I would say. Wayne playing with similar pace to his last bowl, looks to have about a line. Close. Can he get back? Just feathered the jack. Looks like Jenny and Roger are going to get on the board at last. I would say you look a bit heavy, Roger. And a bit wide. That's probably how I'd have bowled it, quite honestly. Well, the ankle pair finally on the board after end six. That'll be a relief to them, that's for sure. Yep, 11-1 after six ends. Doesn't look too bad. Yeah, good start for Jenny. Well played. I know how to pick my partners outdoors. Just hope she can skip as well as she can lead. Beck slightly over the pace of her first ball. Got a yard through. 4 feet. Just gone through. Good bowl there, Jenny. 2 feet through. Beck's just gone on a wider line this time. Weight's a lot better. Jenny don't like that one. Yeah, just a little bit overweight. Good weight from Jenny, but just tight across the head. Beck's on a better line, according to Wayne. It's a weight like. Well, that's definitely the loosest end that Beck's has played so far. She's been exceptional, first five ends, six ends. Roger, looking to get a close ball here. Not quite going to make the distance, I don't think. That's a good line from Wayne. Still one to Roger and Jenny, I'd say. What's your weight like this time, Roger? Your line's better, that's for sure. Dip inside that bolt. Just gone a couple of feet through. Wayne's just gone a little bit wider again on this ball. Struggling to get back. Obviously a difficult length, this one. This is the loosest end they've had. Now Roger, can you capitalise? Weight's much better. Can you fall off those bowls? Oh, fantastic weight. Just not the line, sadly, for Roger. Wayne's pacing after this one, which would suggest he's fairly close. Yep. Just got to stop. Yeah, well played. Well played. Can't afford to give him too many chances. Roger looks to be on a better line here. Can he get back to the jack? Or oh, Wayne's bow even. Just going to slide past. Oh, great effort. Wayne, of course, with last bowl. Holding one, I'd suggest. He's got a strained look on his face, which means he's fairly close, I'd suggest. Just needs to bend back here. Yeah. Yeah, you can always tell by that strained look that he's close. Looks like another couple to Bex and Wayne. Two more to Bex and Wayne. That makes the score 13-1 after seven ends to the pair from Norfolk Bowls Club. If my memory serves me correct, Bex and Wayne are also the current national mixed pairs holders outdoors. Won the title last summer at Leamington. I was there for that. Certainly a difficult pair to beat, these two. You've got to be really playing at your best to compete. Going to hand you back to the main man, Mr. Nichols, for a little while I take a short break. Hope you're all enjoying the stream tonight. Sorry about some of the technical difficulties. Sometimes they're beyond Paul's control. But hopefully you're all enjoying it. Just hand you back to Paul.
Hi everyone. Yeah, as Tony just said, we've just got a couple of tech issues with the audio, but I'm sure we'll sort that out for the next one, so don't worry too much about that. But yeah, great start from Wayne and Beck so far. Certainly the start that they would have wanted. So still plenty of time left in this match, but I think if Jenny and Roger are going to make their move, I think they want to be doing it fairly quick, because they don't want to drop too many more shots in this match without trying to get off that one, because they're 12 shots behind, but there's still 11 ends left to play. Don't forget, this is 18 ends. This is EIBA rules, which means 18 ends, and if the jack goes out of rink, it means it's a dead end and that end is replayed. There's no respots in this particular pairs, whereas last night, the game that we streamed at Beckles, that was open pairs, which meant if the jack went out of rink, it was respotted. So slightly different format, slightly different rules in the open pairs, but this is the normal national mixed pairs. 18 ends, jack out, dead end.
How's Dan get on?
15-13 to Leslie.
Finished?
No, still playing.
So just to give you an update then.
Terrible. Shocking.
Yeah, the update on the other two bowl singles going on at the Norfolk Bowling Club, the semi-final of the two bowl singles. Apparently, Jake Leslie is 15-13 up. So, close game. Sounds like they're having a real good game. That's between Dan Seaborn and Jake Leslie. Jake Leslie is 15-13 up. And as Tony said earlier, I play the winner of their game, so that will be the final. So whoever wins their game will be in the area final, and that will be coming up over the next few weeks. I don't know what we're going to do about streaming that game, because of course I'm going to need someone to actually... Okay, so the score is now 16 apiece, so Dan Seaborn and Jake Leslie. The score is now 16 all, so real close game. Who's your money on though, Tony? What do you think? Obviously you're not going to say Jake.
Well, after Dan not having any sleep for the last 24 hours, after being on a flight back from holiday and then going straight to work this morning at 4 o'clock.
Yeah, apparently Dan has been on holiday and he flew back today, I think, or yesterday. So yeah, it sounds like they're having a close old game. Great ball by Wayne. He's just pushed that out. Looks like could be three or four down. Was it five? Could be five down. So I think Roger just needs to draw one in here and just limit the damage, I think, at this stage. Oh, and he doesn't look far away. Doesn't look far away at all. What a bowl this is. Oh, he's bowled one here. Oh, well played, Roger. What a bowl. Well played, buddy. He was only five down, that's all. Just takes it in his stride, don't he? Just walks.
The
thing about Roger is he acts the same whether he's holding five or if he was eight down. you wouldn't be able to tell.
Man who
Well, Jack goes out. So it's a dead end then. So that's a dead end, so it looks like they're going to be leaving the balls down that end, and then they're going to replay this end going back up. I hope you've all enjoyed this week's games, because today is the last stream for a few days. I'm going to be taking a few days off because it's been a busy week, extremely busy. Tuesday we had the singles between Catherine and Bex. Catherine won 21-18, I think it was, or 21-19, really close game. So we streamed that on Tuesday. Great start by Bex. Perfect. That was on Tuesday night. And then last night we had the open pairs semi-final. Last night we had the open pairs semi-final at Beckles. And Martin Rumble and Dan Poole won that. So they're now in the area final. And they're going to be against either Steve Johnson or James Segolo. So that's going to be the other semi-final. And obviously tonight, Wayne against Roger. Whoever wins this books their place at the national finals in Bristol in the next few weeks. But we've got lots more games coming up over the next few weeks. We have the men's singles, the men's pairs, the ladies singles, the men's fours, men's two bowl singles, the family pairs as well. That should be a good one. The family pairs. Ian Catchpole is in the final at the moment, as far as I know.
All right.
And
his brother-in-law.
Ian Catchpole and Matt, yeah.
Matty Wise.
And they are, I think the other semi-final is yet to be played. So they're in the final for that. So that's the family pairs. So
lost in the area final last season to Aaron Johnson.
Yeah, he did, yeah.
And his dad.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. The whole thing.
Yeah. So yeah, lots more games like coming up over the next few weeks. But for now, I think after tonight's game I'm gonna be taking a few days off. It's been a long week. If you're not already subscribed to Bowls TV as of yet, then it would be awesome if you can head on over, subscribe to our channel and support us over there. It will be really good if you can become a subscriber of ours. It's completely free to do so. All you have to do is just go over, click subscribe, click on the icon, and you get notified of any future games coming up. And also don't forget, we have our main sponsor, Bush Hill Bowls. So just give a shout out to our main sponsor. They've supported Bowls TV over the last couple of months, and they're going to be our main sponsor for the next few months as well. So they have, Bush Hill Bowls have got an online store, bushhillbowls.co.uk, and they've also got a store in London as well, in Enfield. So you buy lots of accessories, bowls equipment, clothing, whatever you need. Contact Bush Hill Bowls for all of your needs. So a quick update. The result of the tonight's semi-final of the other two bowl singles is Dan Seaborn 21-16. So that was against Jake Leslie. So Dan Seaborn won 21-16. That is the area final. That was the area semi-final. So I now play Dan in the final. So that will be coming up probably in the next few weeks at some point. And then whoever wins out of me and Dan will book their place at the national finals. That will be at Nottingham at the end of March at some point. So it should be a good game.
He got home.
Me versus Dan. So well done. Well done to Dan for winning that. He's through to the final.
I don't know what he's playing at. I said to him, you got to be bloody mad.
Yeah.
Why don't you put the day off work? Oh, I can't. There's no one to cover. That's it. Both out. It seems just that Jake's not happy. Stormed off.
So that's another dead end then. Wayne came down the middle, blew it wide open, and the jack went out. So we're now playing back down after another dead ends. Sound is not knackered, we just muted the microphone for 5 minutes, but just so we could have a quick chin wag and a drink. So we are here, and if we ever mute our microphone, you can still hear the game through the mobile phone, so there's always going to be sound coming through the phone. So don't worry, we're here everybody, we haven't left you. There's no problem, we're still here. So as I was saying a few moments ago, lots more games coming up over the next couple of weeks. So stay tuned to Bowls TV and Bowls TV on Facebook as well, so you can stay up to date with all the future games coming up. I do certainly feel though that Bowls TV has is really starting to take off now, though, because this, like, some of the numbers that we've had on some of our streams over the last few weeks have been quite impressive, just for like normal midweek games. So yeah, the numbers are good, and the more subscribers we get, the more people we can reach on YouTube, and then the more people come in and watch, and then more subscribers we get. So as a result, the players get a lot more exposure, the sport gets a lot more exposure, more eyeballs on the sport, which is always a good thing. Always improvements to make, though, as I've been saying over the last 6 months. I mean, a couple of months ago, the target was to obviously have two mobile phones like we've got now, two cameras, one either ends, and we run everything through the software, and that's what we're doing right now, and everything is good. The only thing that we do need to focus on, I would say the next thing that we're going to focus on and try to improve, is I'm going to buy some different cameras. The cameras that we're going to get, I'll be able to remotely move them around from my station, so I can sit here with like a fancy little control pad and a joystick, and I can zoom in. So that will be like, that will be next level. That'll be a game changer. So we'll be able to move everything around, and then if we've got any cameras up the side of the rink as well, we can switch rounds. But the cameras are not cheap. Obviously, that's something that we're going to have to invest in over the next six months or so. But certainly, lots more improvements to make. But when we get these new cameras where I can zoom in and zoom out and move it around, that will be a game changer. The games will be brilliant to watch then, because, like for now, for instance, because it's a three-quarter jack, you just can't quite see the head. But with these new cameras, I'm going to be able to zoom in, and I'll be able to zoom in on the bowl as it comes down the green, just like you do it at Potters and the Scottish Open and other championships. So yeah, lots more awesome stuff to come. Yeah, someone just said, I think it was Darren, he mentioned that the camera has got a bit of a slope on it. Yeah, I do see what you mean. It does have a little bit of a slope, or it certainly looks like that. I mean, when you look at the camera from here, it looks perfectly level. But I think it could be one of the tripod legs is just not completely extended out. So I'll go over and have a look at that in a second. Now that I've just seen that, that's going to annoy me. That's going to bug me until I change it. So I'll go over there in a second, I'll change it. But yeah, thanks for that. So where is everybody watching this from tonight then? Who is the furthest away watching this game? Last night we had a chap from Texas, and he was sat, I think he was at home watching bowls. He was watching the open pairs. He was at home in Texas, and it was 22 degrees. Lovely. And there was another chap as well, a few days ago. He was from Virginia. He might even be on here again tonight. I can't remember the chap's name. Terry, I think it might be. I can't quite remember, but if you're listening, buddy, the chap from Virginia, are you here tonight? And Texas. Well played, Wayne. He's just drew another. Is there anybody on the beach watching this? The most random of places. There was somebody in the last summer said, "Oh, I'm on holiday. I'm watching this on the beach."
Really?
Yeah, in Australia, someone like that. Yeah, I've had some really random places. I just can't hear you too well, mate. Terry Edens, there he is. Terry Edens, he's the chap. Terry from Virginia. I'm in a beach town, does that count? Probably not, no.
Good evening, Terry.
Can't hear.
Would it be good morning? I'm not really sure. What time is in Kentucky?
What's going on with the commentary tonight? I don't know. This is strange. Very odd. Just let me know, everybody, how clear my audio is tonight, because for some reason, quite a few people have been saying that this is not very loud. So just let me know, please. Yeah, I just read that, yeah. Possibly, yeah, in the future we will, yeah. Yeah, just let me know, because I've not changed anything tonight with my audio. This is the same as what I normally use. Well, I'm using a different headset, but that's not going to make any difference. Just let me know if my audio is nice and clear, please. Audio could do with coming up by about 4 decibels. Well, that's very strange, because I've been using this same audio. I've been using this same microphone every single time. So that is very strange. Sorry about that, I just forgot to change screens. So that last end, Wayne and Bex, they picked up a single. They picked up a single on that last end. So what we got here? There we go, 14-1 after 8 ends. Right, what I'm going to do. Is. I'm going to try and adjust my audio slightly. Let me change something over and see if it makes any difference. I normally use the blue one. Right, let me know what this audio is like. I've just changed over my headset back to my blue one, back to a different one that I normally use. So I've not changed anything else. Let me know what the audio is like now. If you can hear me okay. This is the one I used last night, so It should be nice and clear. It should be nice and loud. There's no reason why there should be any issues. Way too low. Well, that is very, very strange. So it's too low. Well, I've not done anything different to last night. What about if I change this? So let me know, everybody, what this is like. Well, Wayne's just came down again, and it's not much Roger and Jenny can do, because the moment that head starts to build up, Wayne is straight into it. So I've just turned the microphone up slightly. Let's see how much difference there is now. So let me know, everybody. Let me know what you think. Does it sound okay? Well, that could be the shot then. Roger may have just drew the shot, but I think that's too much space for Wayne, really. Now I'm louder. You still seem fine to me. Could be something there, Enns. Yeah, I've just adjusted my audio slightly. Now I'm louder. Okay. Spot on. Okay, well, we'll just leave it like this for now. I think what it is when some people listen to the game on their phone, it can sometimes seem quite like pretty quiet, because you can't always hear much on the phone. No. I've listened back to my games,
I've always found the volume fine.
Yeah. Okay. Thing is, sometimes I talk more quiet because at the moment there's people in here and it's quite noisy. But if you can imagine, if there was no one here and just the game going on, I can't talk very loud because they'll hear me. Yeah. So, yeah, it is difficult sometimes. Well, is Roger, I think Roger's holding one here. He got a ball to come, so he could pick up a two here. God, Roger. You calm down, Roger. Just yeah, Jenny and Roger have been playing okay. It's just that Wayne is having one of them games where the moment any kind of head builds up, he's straight into it. He's running at it, and to be honest, he's very, very hard to beat when his runners are on target. So Roger would love to get another one in here. He's not too far. I think that's going to finish, because it really finishes on this carpet. Yeah, well played, Roger. Yeah, well done. So two shots to Roger and Jenny. Well done. The comeback is on. Okay. You're listening through Creative Pebbles surround sound through your Xbox. Okay, well, I think sometimes it can come down to what device that you're listening to the stream on. Condenser microphone will cut out what's around me. Stephen Curtis. Yeah, Stephen, the thing is, the reason why you can always hear a little bit of background noise, I do that on purpose. Each phone at the end of the green, see, like now, if I switch cameras over, well, I'll leave it as it is. So at the moment you can see you're watching from the bottom end, so you can now hear all the audio coming from that phone. So you can hear Roger talk and Wayne talk if they talk amongst themselves, because everything from that phone, it will pick up a lot of the audio. I've turned the audio down so it's not very sensitive, but I do that on purpose so you can hear the players talk. When we switch cameras up the other end of the green, it will automatically pick up audio from the other phone and then switch off the one down here. And this is how the stream works. Now, I could turn the volume completely off on both phones so you can't hear the players talk or anything like that. But I do that just so you can get a little bit more context as to what's going on in the match, like with the players talking to each other. Unfortunately, you will sometimes get people walk past and tell their mate a story, and that sometimes gets picked up, you know, what they had for dinner the day before. Yeah, and that's just one of them things, and I can't control that. Yeah, some people aren't always aware of the camera is on. So that's why you can always hear sounds coming from the stream. But you'll also obviously hear me talk as well. So it just depends how noisy it is in the club. If you've got lots of people walking around, you're going to hear a lot more coming through the phones. I just think if the stream is too quiet, it doesn't always seem very...
Get the atmosphere, don't you?
Yeah, as Tony just said, you don't always get the atmosphere if it's too quiet, because when you're watching a game here, you know, there's people here and people clap and cheer and all sorts. So I think, personally, that's important to sort of try to pick a lot of that up on the stream as well. Someone just said there's no sex noises like there was in the bowls, is there? Do you know what? I know exactly what you mean. I didn't know about that until someone, where did I see that? I think it was the BBC. The BBC said something about that, and there was all these noises like that came over on the speaker. I was, oh God. And then it happened again.
Yeah, that's right.
It came over the... Oh, God. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. And everybody in the audience just didn't know what to do. And it came, yeah, it was so...
That stopped the players in their tracks.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, okay. I do listen to all the comments. But remember, we've only been doing this for 6 months, so there's always room for improvement. And yeah, I do take things on board. You know, I certainly listen to people's feedback. You know, I'm never going to say, no, that's a waste of time telling me that. You know, everyone's entitled to an opinion. So... even if I don't always agree with people's opinion, that's, you know, everyone is entitled to one, so that's fine. But as you probably all know, we did only start our Bowls TV channel back in July. In fact, the man sat next to me, Tony, that was me and him, we did our first stream, didn't we?
We did.
Back in July. That was Andy Seeley against Jack Latter. Yeah, seems like a lifetime ago. And it was
lots happened since then.
It was in the middle of the summer, and it was about 24 degrees, and we kind of didn't. Well, it was kind of just to make it up as you go along.
Yeah,
I had an app, didn't I? And yeah. I think I left the comments on, didn't I, from the app. Yeah, it was all right. Yeah, it wasn't bad.
What people have got to bear in mind is we've had no live streaming before in the past whatsoever.
Yeah.
So, you know, what you're doing is absolutely phenomenal.
Yeah. No, I do feel like we're certainly on the right track and we're certainly headed in the right direction. It's taken a lot of work, but still lots more to come. And we have Wendy King in the chat box. Hello, Wendy.
That's the Wendy King, then. Good evening.
No, it isn't Wendy King. No, there's actually a bowler, Wendy, called Wendy King.
Yeah.
Now, Wendy King is a friend of mine. Oh, right. She's married to a guy that I know. That I used to race with. Yeah, Wendy King. Hello, Wendy. What are you doing on here? Shouldn't you be at work on a Thursday night? Wendy King is watching this because I think she's gonna take up bowls, I think. Ah, well played, Roger. What a bowl.
What a bowl that was.
Yeah. You're showing your support. Are you subscribed though to Bowls TV?
Yeah, that's the key question.
Yeah. Her husband has also got he runs a YouTube channel. He's good on YouTube as well. And he asked me to subscribe. He was on I think he was on something like 1498 or 99, and he asked me, he said, please subscribe so I can hit 1500. So I subscribed and then I unsubscribed when I got home. So he got to he got to 1500, but then I got home and unsubscribed, and then the next time I saw him, he complained. Why did you unsubscribe? Why did you unsubscribe? So Wendy, are you gonna start bowl soon? So Wayne with his last bowl then. It looks like Roger and Jenny are holding one. But we'll see what Wayne decides to play here. I don't think he's going to do anything too ambitious. By the sound of it, yeah. At this stage of the game, yeah. After 10 ends, 14-4. Yeah, so a single then. So Jamie said he'll take me down in bowls. Well, that's what he said to me about pool. And then I played him at pool. I don't think he's ever beat me at pool, has he? Right then. So Wayne and Bex, they drop a one. So a single to Roger and Jenny. So it's now 14-4. So the score then is now 14-4 to Wayne and Bex. So they're 10 shots in front, but still 8 ends left to play. So certainly still a good chance for Roger and Jenny to come back in this match. But they definitely need to make their move quick, and they don't really want to be dropping too many more shots. Yeah, great start by Jenny. Well played. I've got an idea anyway. I'll keep this on as well. I did say it yesterday. I don't know if everyone really thought it, it. Maybe people didn't think it was a very good idea. Right. But you know, you get a lot of people standing in front of the camera.
Yeah.
I come up with a really good idea.
Go on.
Because
this will
stop people from, and plus it will probably make the game a bit more fun. Right. So if you give everybody an electric bracelet or some kind of vibration bracelet and put it around their waist or their leg,
right.
And then as soon as someone stands in the way of the camera, you can push a button.
Give them a shock.
And they'll give a shock. And that gives a shock out. Now, I don't know if that'll take off.
You've had some ideas in the past, Paul, but that's going a little bit radical, I'd say. Obviously, it was some bowlers, it might make them play better. Me, for example, when we're doing a few electric shots during the game.
Let's keep you awake. Come back, yeah. Well, you never know. Bowls is a funny game, and sometimes you just never know. Certainly going to be tough against Wayne and Bex, but you just never know. You know, all you can do is just keep putting them on,
and just
keep doing it. So how many people have we got watching tonight then? I did look earlier. I think it was about, 250, I think? 240, something like that. So, yeah. Not bad. Our record still stands at 338.
What game was that?
That was Wayne against Mark.
Oh, right, yeah. Champion.
Yeah. Yeah, that was...
Yeah, that was... I was expecting that to be a lot tighter than what it was in the end.
Yeah,
that game.
Yeah.
Wayne played especially well that night, didn't he?
Mm.
Mark was the defending champion.
Yeah, yeah. Watching on the TV in Louth.
Lincolnshire.
Ah, is it?
Yeah.
Lincolnshire?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Louth Indoor Bowls Club.
Yeah, awesome. Hello, Veronica. Veronica Ball. Oh, it was a great bowl by Wayne. I think he's just drew that. So see what Roger can do here, because...
Mile away.
Yeah, he's not a million miles away, is he?
What?
Oh, I think he might have just been a bit unlucky. I think he's just pushed that jack through. Oh, it's close. Oh. So it could be holding to, it could be one down. That looks like Wayne and Bex won that measure then. So after 11 ends, we'll find out in just a second exactly how many shots that actually was, but I think it might be one, it could be two. But it's definitely 11 ends. I think it was one. Yeah, so just a single shot then. So a single shot then to Wayne and Bex. So 15-4. 15-4 is the score. I just want to say thanks everybody for tuning in on another weeknight, Thursday night. So we've had over 200 people tune in earlier. So yeah, it's been a good stream. This is obviously the first area final that we've live streamed for this winter season. Philip says he thought I was giving players electric shocks as they're all well behaved. Just to let me know, the sound has gone off. Yeah, well, it's because I've muted my microphone. You don't want to hear me and Tony have a chinwag. We're just discussing lots of different secrets and
top secret
bowl stuff. Yeah, you can't be listening to our conversation. So just to let you all know then, what is going to be coming up over the weekends. Earlier on I said I was going to have a little bit of a break, didn't I, from live streaming. Well, I was wrong. I completely forgot, didn't I, that I'm going to be possibly live streaming this weekend. Now, I don't know how it's going to go. The Open Single Circuit is at the Norfolk Bowling Club this weekend. I'm playing on Saturday night. And I was going to stream the games on Sunday, but we don't know how it's going to work because the signal's not very good. So it might be a good idea just to get some feedback from everybody on the stream now. So if the signal, well, I know the signal's not very good at the bowling club. No. Would you rather still watch the games from a single camera, or would you not bother, or would you? Do you just think that's not worth it? Because this is obviously a money tournament. This is an open singles circuit event. The winner gets around £1,000 and runner-up gets like £500.
I will be there. Sunday?
Yeah.
Coming along.
So let me know what you think. Would you like to see me stream it from a single phone? Because unfortunately, the network isn't good enough to have two cameras. You all know that anyway. I've said that 100 times before. So would you like to see me still stream some of the games from a single phone so at least you can still see what's going on? Or would you do you think it's just not worth it and just leave it? So I'm not really sure what to do. Yeah. So Paul Hewitt just said it's better than nothing. Yeah, it is, Paul, and I agree. However, this is a proper tournament, and like for instance, if it ever goes to a tie break on the crucial tie break ends and it's up the other end of the green, I'm not going to see anything. So we're going to be down here just pulling our hair out. I mean, what do we do? I don't know. I don't know what to do. Well played, Roger. Just try that, Jack. So we'll just have to have a think about what to do for the weekends, whether we do stream or we don't. Well, one of the things I did think about is walking up and down the green. Now, that hasn't been agreed yet. We need to agree that with obviously the players and the actual club themselves. We've not agreed exactly what we're going to do yet, but I've been talking to Chris Taylor about it, and we haven't decided exactly what the best thing is to do yet. So we'll just see. We'll have to. Yeah, he did. Yeah, it's been done before when you walk up and down the green. It isn't brilliant. However, you do get to see both ends. But the only downside to that at the bowling club is that because the signal's not very good, I might lose a signal if I walk up the other end. Yeah, I don't know. I'll have to have a think about it tomorrow. But if you do want to pop along, by all means you can pop along and watch it live in person. That is the Norfolk Bowling Club on Unthank Road in Norwich. So you can pop along. There's going to be some games on Saturday evening from 6 p.m. and then some more games from 7:30. And then the Sunday games. I think the first game on Sunday is 8:30. First thing. 8:30 in the morning. So if you do want to pop along and have a watch, then of course you're welcome to do so. Well played, Wayne. You can't see what's going on here, but Wayne has just drew the shot. Roger was holding the shot. He's about 18 inches short, but Wayne has just drew the shot within about 8 or 9 inches, and Roger's now trying to... Well, he's not far away. Oh, dear, Roger, what an effort. Great effort by Roger. I'm just saying that where we are here at County Arts, we've got there's a bar here and lots of comfy seats, and apparently they're all sat in the bar having a beer watching this game on the smart TV in the bar area, where they could literally walk around the corner and watch it live, but they choose not to. Technology, hey? Well, John Locke has just said his volume is up full, and the volume and the sound is not good. Well, sorry about that, John. I don't know what to say. The thing is, some people say that the audio is fine, other people say that it isn't. So we'll just switch cameras round. So that last end then looks like Wayne and Bex picked up a single. So the score now is 16-4 after 12 ends. So a lot of work to do for Roger and Jenny, but they're just hanging in there at the moment. So 12 shots down with 6 ends left to play. So if they could just pick up maybe a 4 or 5, that would certainly help. Okay, so Alan Backshall is saying he's watching it on YouTube and the sound is good. Philip said the sound is good. YouTube sound is good since I changed something. I don't know, I think I'm just going to give up tonight about the audio. It's just up and down. I've not really changed anything from last night. I'm using the same microphone. Oh dear, oh well. Things to work on for the next few streams. We'll definitely crack this co-commentary thing though. We'll certainly try and test this out for next time, where we have two microphones connected and we can both talk and you can hear us both. But that might just need... Well, no, I've just moved my boom closer to my mouth. Maybe that's what it is then. Maybe when I talk like that, people can't hear me.
Not like that.
Maybe my boom is not close enough to my mouth. Maybe that's what it is then. Something as simple as that. So maybe the secret is just to keep my boom very close to my mouth. Okay, so we've sussed that out tonight at least. Yeah. So it wasn't
closer is better.
It wasn't the audio at all then, it was just my boom. So now what I'll do then is go into my microphone. Well, I'm going to change my microphone volume back down to 100%. Not that that means anything to you guys, but this is just techie stuff. I'm going to change this, so yeah, let me know if that is all still okay. We're still trying to polish these streams up. I mean, I think I've only done about 9, well no, probably more than that actually. I've probably done about 20 streams now with two cameras. So we're still trying to polish things up. Yeah.
Rome wasn't built in a day.
Yeah, absolutely.
Most of us are just grateful for what you're doing.
Yeah. Yeah, watching a Scooby Caravan Man. You do get some strange names. The thing is, though, some of the names I can't actually repeat. Some of the names I can't. Scooby Caravan Man. Are you a bowler? You're watching on your smart TV, YouTube volume fine. Right, okay, so Philip said if I've moved my boom. Okay, so the secret to this particular microphone then is to keep it nice and close to my mouth. Oh dear, it's been a long week. Yeah, I'm now going to pass you over to Tony. So I will pass on the secret to this audio malarkey. The boom has to be close to his mouth. I'm all boomed out, me.
Poor Paul. He's had a long week, ladies and gents. My God, he's doing a great job, though, I have to say. I know I'm a bit biased, forgive the pun. But, wow, this is his third stream this week. I'm just grateful that we've got live polls to watch. Obviously, there'll be some fine-tuning in the weeks and months to come. But I think we're all just grateful that we're able to watch some live bowls. And don't forget that Paul's doing all this under his own steam. Thankfully, he has got some sponsorship from Bush Hill Bowls, which he's very, very grateful for, I'm sure. They're based in Enfield, I believe. So if you've got any bowling equipment requirements, have a look at their website. just want to draw people's attention to a big game tomorrow night, actually, in the Norwich area. It's the national quarter final of the under-30s double rink taking place at Norfolk Bowling Club. And it's Norfolk Bowls Club playing Ipswich. And unusually, both rinks are being played at the one venue. Normally it's home and away. But tomorrow night, you can see both rinks being played at Norfolk Bowls Club. And the winners of that tie go through to the semi-final at Nottingham on the 6th of April, I believe. So a big game in store tomorrow night. And Ipswich have got some very, very good youngsters in their side. That's the under-30s double rink. And Norfolk Bowls Club have got none other than, I believe, Catherine Rednall's playing. And the new national under-25 singles champion, Aaron Johnson, is amongst their team. And big congratulations to Aaron. Fantastic achievement. Not only winning the national under-25 singles, but also winning the family pairs last season with his dad, Stephen. So definitely a man on form. Right, back to the action. We're now playing the 14th event. Current score, according to the scoreboard, 17-4 after 13 ends. Once again, apologies for some of the technical difficulties this evening, but I hope it's not ruined your enjoyment too much. I had a few comments this evening from friends, people, fellow bowlers. Just a shout out to Roy Himpleman from Acle. Nice to hear from you, my friend. Glad you're sharing the coverage of the bowls together with the darts tonight. Hope young Luke Littler is enjoying his Premier League debut. What a talent that boy is. Perhaps we should get him playing bowls as well in his spare time. If you've got any questions for myself or Paul, then don't hesitate. Keep them clean. We'll do our best to provide an answer for you. Paul's very good on the technical side and his bowls knowledge. And if you've got any personal problems you want to share with Paul, I'm sure he'll give you some advice on that as well. Paul says, ask Tony if you've got personal problems. Perhaps we'll save that for another time. Beck's just apologising for putting a bowl a yard past. If that was me playing, I'd be apologising for every bowl. Looks like Jenny's holding here at the moment. Bex has got a second, about a foot in front. I think they really need to get a score on this end to give themselves any chance whatsoever. A large count is required. But Wayne's looking to alter the head again. Let's push Bex's bowl a little bit closer. Rogers looking to draw another. Just gone, I think. No, it's still just the one. Wayne playing a little runner again, see if he can get a connection. Well, that's gone terribly wrong for Wayne. Jenny's just signalled they're holding four. This could be a very interesting finish if they get this end. Rogers looking to add a fifth, and he ain't far away, I tell you. Not far at all. We've drawn a cracker there. That's five. I think the big boom is coming. Get ready, folks. Here it comes. And there it goes. Seldom misses a target, Mr. Willgress. Known him since he was a little lad, if you can believe he was ever a little lad. But he was once. He's just, whenever he's down on the head, he very seldom misses. Yeah, that was a very big moment, that was. Jenny and Roger were looking to gain four or five shots that end. But it was not to be. Anyway, as Paul said earlier, seems to be a lot of big events happening in Norfolk at the moment. We've got the Open Singles Circuit happening this weekend at Norfolk Bowls Club. Not sure yet whether it's going to be streamed, but if you're local, you've got a lot of top local players playing in that event with good prize money. So if you want to get down there, the action starts actually Saturday evening and then all day Sunday. I shall be there Sunday. Possibly Saturday evening, because I think my son's bowling Saturday night, his first round tie, against none other than Tom Krytoff. Big shout out to Tom. That should be a good game. Tom's on form at the moment, I know. Who are you playing first round, Paul?
Josh Finch.
Josh Finch. From Gallo. That should be a good game. Yeah. Jenny's just drawn another. Sitting one on, one about a foot through by the looks of things. Jenny don't like this one so much. Slightly narrow weight looks really good though. If you were with us earlier, you may have heard me say that Jenny does a lot for charity. She's agreed to play with my good self in the mixed pairs, Bowls England mixed pairs outdoors this season. God knows why she wants to play with me, but obviously she likes a laugh. That should be funny if you've seen me bowl lately. Barnes Wallace has got nothing on me. I just about get down to bounce my bowls these days. I try to copy John Wilson. John, you'll know from the World Bowls at Potters. I would say his delivery's probably a little bit smoother than mine, but my God, what a bowler. And what a lad too. He is a top guy. Wayne playing one of his runners again. Oh, he's missed one for a change. That's unusual. Roger looking to add another here. Don't seem that far away. If he misses a front bowl, well, that's his own. I would suggest that Wayne will be a little bit closer this time. He's hardly missed a thing all night. And he's close again. There we are. Well, he's moved it. Not happy with where his bowl's finished. He has got a toucher in a ditch. Bex has just marked the toucher. Roger's asking the question. Jenny reckons they're holding two at the moment, Jenny and Roger. Roger's on a swingy hand, that one.
Nah, that's right.
Very close. Good bowl. Well played, Roger. Very good. I'd say that's shot. Wayne don't like this one. Wow, he's only drawn it. Wayne thought he was into one of the opposition's bowls, but he just got underneath. I don't know if you just heard, Paul, but in the future, when the jack's moved and is either in the ditch or close to the ditch, he's going to try and find a camera that zooms in closer so it can give you a better view of what's happening. But that's in the future, something that Paul's got in the pipeline. Wayne's head in his hands. Oh, Roger's asking the question, how many do they hold? And Jenny's come back with one. This looks slightly different, this bowl. Doesn't look that adjacent. Roger said he's grateful for one. It's been that sort of night for the pair of them from Acor, bless them. So, four ends to go, and there's 12 shots in it. Bex and Wayne, 17. Jenny and Roger, 5. you've got any events coming up that you'd like to let us know of. Be nice to know what else is going on around the country. You know, there's the national finals this weekend of the Champions at the Dolphin Indoor Bowls Club in Dorset. Paul, good luck to everybody who's competing in that at the weekend. As I said earlier, one of my favourite clubs. Anyone going down to watch, you're in for a treat. Jenny's found a limp on this end. Well played, Jen. Well played. Very good. She's some bowler, and she'll need to be when she gets outdoors with me. Beck's trying to follow it up, but she's finished. Oh, good 4 feet short. That's one of the worst bowls she's played tonight. She's been exceptional. Yep, Jenny's adding another. You holding three presently. Bexy's better here. She's better here. She's got good weight here. What a bowl this is. What a bowl. Oh, second. She'll be pleased with that, though. She was three down. Jenny looking to just... Well, she's got a little bit more pace than I thought she'd have, but she's looking to turn Bex's bowl away. She ain't far away. Oh, just got the front bowl, just caught the front bowl. Wasn't that far away. Beck's looking to get another one in the head now. She's looking to close this head down. Yeah, Wayne's happy with that. Just while they're changing over, I just want to give a shout out, if I may, and please forgive me. Good friend of ours, many bowlers will know, a gentleman by the name of Rhys Lee. He's recovering in hospital at the moment. Just want to send our love and best wishes to Rhys. I won't go into specifics, but he's a top guy, and just want to know that we're all thinking of him, and good luck with his recovery. Close. Gets inside that front bowl. No, just got wrecked on that.
line just outside the line, I think. Yeah, just not coming back. His weight weren't bad. Roger's trying to walk their head with this one. Playing with a couple of yards. Oof. I think Wayne likes this one. Nope. Didn't quite have that same strained look on his face he normally has when he's close. Roger's trying to force things a little here. Can he get the gap? No, he's just cannoned into Wayne Spole. I think Jenny and Roger are still holding at the moment. Wayne's looking like he likes this one. Can he bend? Can he bend under? Oh, what an effort that was. Yep, Beck's the same one. And that is it. Jenny and Roger have conceded the game. So, massive congratulations to Beck's and Wayne, who now make it through to the national finals at Bristol later on in February, I believe. So, big congratulations to them. Just want to say a big thank you to everyone who's tuned in tonight. And I want to say a massive thanks to Paul Nichols for all his efforts. I mean, what he's done with this live streaming has been unbelievable. Bearing in mind we've had nothing to watch for many, many years. So, yeah, we've had a few technical issues tonight, but I hope that hasn't spoilt your enjoyment too much. Paul's got lots of plans in the pipeline for the future. And he deserves the massive support from all of us, really. So if you've got time, if you've not subscribed already to Bowls TV, we would very much appreciate if you would do that for us. And I'd say there's plenty more games coming up in the future for us all to enjoy. So thanks very much, Paul, for everything you've done. I'll hand you back now for Paul. And good night, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed the stream.
Well, cheers, Tony. Thanks for the kind words. There's that fiver, mate. Nah, that's nice to... Yeah, always nice to get some good feedback and nice comments. So that is that. That is the end of tonight's stream. Thanks, everybody. As Tony said, we thank you all for tuning in, on a weeknight. Yeah, it wasn't meant to be for Roger and Jenny tonight. It was always going to be a very difficult game against Wayne and Bex, two top-class players, as you all probably already know. But Jenny and Roger, two very good players and done very well to get through to the final. But tonight, they just really come up against it. And Wayne wasn't really missing many of his runners. But congratulations to Wayne and Bex. So they now book their place at the national finals for the mixed pairs. Who they have, we don't know yet. So they're going to be at Bristol in the next few weeks, I think. And we wish them the best of luck in their first game. So that is the end of tonight's live stream. And I hope that you've enjoyed the game. I feel like it's been a very good game technically, apart from just a little bit of the audio and a few audio issues early on in the stream. But apart from that, I really think that the actual stream, the network speed and everything, the signal has been really, really good. Not had any technical issues at all, really, apart from a couple of audio things. But we'll get that addressed for the next stream, so we can get two people on the microphone at the same time. So that's just a couple of technical things that we need to adjust. But thanks, everybody. As Tony said, don't forget to subscribe to Bowls TV if you're not already. Also, we are on Facebook. Bowls TV is on Facebook as well. And also Bowls Talk Norfolk. Tony is one of the admins on Bowls Talk Norfolk, so you can go there as well and join his group. So thanks, everybody. Coming up will be the Open Singles event this weekend. We don't know yet if we're going to be streaming at all, but if you keep an eye on the YouTube channel and the Facebook page, we'll keep you updated as to what's going to happen over this weekend. But that is it for me, and that is it from Tony. Just like to say thanks, Tony, for coming along today. Always good to have him along, and he is a good commentator. I'm sure you'd all agree. He's good on the old microphone, so it's good to have someone else here for a change. But that is it from me and from us tonight from Bowls TV. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed tonight's game. We will see you again very soon, perhaps this weekend, when we cover the Open Singles Circuit from right here in Norwich from the Norfolk Bowling Club. So thanks, everybody. Bye for now.